done to one of our workers. You know what I'm sick of over the last few months, whether you're an in or an outer in this European campaign, both sides telling you that they were on the side of workers.
Yeah.
Well, this is the reality, whether you were in or whether you were out. This guy was sacked before the election took place. We've had it now and he's still sacked.
Yeah.
The reality is that companies like this were allowed by this government to jump on a passing bandwagon that they call the living wage, that we call the joke living wage, and allow them to claw that money back. And that is absolutely disgraceful, considering when you see the abysmal wages that these people were paid right from the start. So first of all, we've got to take the campaign to make sure that not only Coumarin is reinstated, but that people are repaid the money that the company's trying to take away from them. I've got to say, I didn't know Coumarin before conference. I'd seen photos of him. You know, this is not a revolutionary. Believe it or not, he's not an anarchist, he's not a troublemaker. This is a guy who had the courage of his convictions to stand up against an oppressive employer. And this company is nothing but an oppressive employer. They're seeking to deny trade union recognition in the face of when we've got 50% and above of the people in here in the union already. And that's something that is going to continue to grow, and I hope that you will help us along that journey. I say, he's a decent bloke who's just fought for fairness. Trumped up charges, and that's all we can say that he is, and we've got our lawyers working on it as well at the moment. They are trumped up charges. If this guy was a bully, if he was a bully, they would have found out. It wouldn't take them 12 years with an impeccable record, not in a union, and then all of a sudden he joins a union, he starts speaking up for people to find out that he's a troublemaker or he's a bully or whatever. So we disregard the charges that are made against him, and we will do everything in our power as a trade union. You know, I hope that we make the Candy Udwin protest look like small pride with the things that we're going to do. We've got global support. I've got letters off Francis O'Grady, Ron Oswald, who's the General Secretary of the International Union of Food Workers, Doug Nicholls, who's the General Secretary of the General Federation of Trade Unions, and all the unions who were present at the Trade Union Coordinating Group last week. All of those people send messages of support for Coumarin. But you know, we can do stuff as well. We put down EDMs, and we're going to have an MP speaking later on, Richard Bergen. We put down an EDM already, so you get your MP to get up and support that EDM when it comes and make sure that it delivers. I want to finish off, Chair, by just saying, the worst thing that a private company likes, or hates, sorry, is they hate their brand being affected.
Yeah.
And this is the thing, that if we've got to escalate this, the next thing we do is we find out every product that this company makes right across all its factories, and then we take it out into the community. We tell people, we tell trade union members that we boycott it until these people reinstate Coumarin Beaufort. You as individuals can write to the company, write to Paul Davey by all means, but go on their complaints line, exactly the same as we did at Hovis in Wigan, and tell the company, unless they reinstate this man, then we're not going to buy your product, and that'll stop your profits. You won't be able to donate to the Tory party anymore. Solidarity, comrades. Let's get it back to work.
Cheers. Listen, obviously, this campaign doesn't just obviously contain Baker's Union, as you can tell from the people around here today, and some of the most important people are from different organisations, and I'm pleased to welcome one of those people that's been at the forefront of organising the events of around here, and that's Michael Barker, who's from the local Socialist Party, I believe. Welcome.
Thank you very much for letting me speak today. I just want to extend our solidarity from the Socialist Party. I mean, right from the start of this campaign, we realised it was very important. Attacks on workers' wages always are, and people need to fight back. And Coumarin has shown in a brilliant way how people are fighting back within the factories across Leicester. And it's really disgusting that there's been disciplinary action being taken against other union reps as well at this very moment. I mean, the entire case around what's going on with Coumarin is ridiculous, in that Coumarin put in a complaint after working for the company for 12 years against management, and then they came back by putting in a counter complaint against him, saying he was bullying management. I mean, it's completely ridiculous. It probably goes on every day around the country. It doesn't make it less ridiculous or more important to fight back. And that there's more than 50% of people wanting to join a union in his workplace is ridiculous. That the bosses say that well, you don't need a union because we have staff consultative committees. And these staff consultative committees are totally toothless, as they were meant to be. And anyway, totally appalling, really. I mean, so one of the things I've tried to do, other than trying to help organise protests and solidarity stuff, is try to write short articles about what's been going on, submit them to local newspaper. And I've submitted quite a few over the last few months, none of which appeared in press. So I still have a blog called Thoughts of a Leicester Socialist that has been used for some of the Bakers Union leaflets. So if people want to find out more about the campaign, have a look at that. I mean, last year I stood for Parliament for Leicester East, for the Trade Unionists and Socialist Coalition as well, because I think it's important to give people, you know, a political alternative to the mainstream politics that we have at the moment, which is just about austerity. I mean, Jeremy Corbyn has shown that people can oppose austerity, except he can't seem to do it within the Labour Party at the moment because his hands are very much tied, although we think he should be opposing austerity and kicking out all the right-wingers within the Labour Party. I was one of the few people who wrote to local press and stuff during his election campaign, actually saying that this is a good person who should be leader of the Labour Party. And I pressed other members of the Labour Party in Leicester to support that. And not a single one came forward, unfortunately. But in the case of Coomeran's campaign, at least, a few Labour Party MPs have stepped forward to put a tiny bit of pressure to help his case. And so every little bit counts. And so we're trying to use them as well we can to make sure that unions get recognised on these sites and across the country as soon as possible.
Thank you very much. Okay, obviously, the importance of the trade union movements in the communities is headed up by the local trade union council. So we're pleased to welcome Tony Church from the local Leicester and Melton and Mowbray trade union council of here anyway. Cheers.
Thank you, and like everybody else, we're here because we're giving full support to Coomeran. We think what the company's done is disgraceful. We're here to protect union rights, to extend union rights, and to make the role of the trade unions the role that it should have. But I have to say as well as being secretary of the Leicester and District Trade Union Council, I'm also a group officer for the DWP group of PCS. And I want to say that PCS fully supports this. I come from a campaigning union, and the Bakers Union is a campaigning union. And it's the campaigning unions that are going to change the face of Britain. Because what we're seeing today, whilst we're fighting this battle, we're seeing people trying to destabilise the Labour Party in terms of jumping ship around Jeremy Corbyn. And that isn't an accident. That's been planned for months. That's about trying to make sure that we don't get somebody who's going to fight austerity. And austerity means that employers like Samworth can get away with what they're trying to do at the moment. It means that Samworths can go on victimising workers. And we have to say, as the organised trade union movement, no they can't. No they won't. We won't let them. We'll stand in solidarity. And I think it's about time in this country that we realise that the battles that the trade unions are fighting are one common battle. And that is a battle against austerity. And whether you're in or out, it doesn't really matter, because the EU believe in austerity. The British government believe in austerity. And whether we were in or out, we'd still be fighting austerity. So we'd have to continue that fight. And I think it's an indictment of the trade union movement that we're seeing all these sort of things of which Coomeran is a part. And yet the trade union movement, the official trade union movement, has done very little about it. Some years ago, I went to lobby the TUC. The TUC agreed that a step forward would be a 24-hour general strike, something we've not seen in Britain for a long time, although on the day that millions took to the street over pensions being robbed in the public sector, we saw almost that general strike. But now we need to say to the TUC, yeah, this is the time when we need a fight back.
We need to take on the Sandwith Brothers of the world. We need to take on all these bad employers. And we need to take on the government. Because whilst austerity politics exists in Britain, Coomeran's story will be repeated time and time and time again. And now's the time to say, we're not having any more of it. We're going to stand up to that. We're going to fight. And if the official movement doesn't do that, if the Labour Party won't lead that fight, and TUC won't lead that fight, then the pressure has got to come from below. I'm very proud to be a member of the National Stop Shop Stewards Network, and I know the Bakers Union support the NSSN. And there's a conference taking place in London on this coming Saturday where activists will have a chance about the fight back. And it is important that we have a big attendance at that. It's a rank and file organisation. And in the final analysis, it's the rank and file who will make the leaders move. If they don't want to move, the rank and file has to make them move. So full support to Coomeran, full support to the trade union movement, full support to those fighting austerity. Thank you.
Just come back. I love you.